Hare Krishna. To think that we have no vice is to be a novice. Novices are people who are very new in a field. So, normally say if somebody is a novice computer programmer, then they don't know how to do the programming, what are the codes, what are the keys associated with particular codes, and they have to learn everything. So, novices are often people who are in a learning mood, and that by learning they will grow towards perfection, towards improvement, towards excellence also. Now, on the spiritual path, however, when we are novices, when we start practicing bhakti, say, sometimes we may think that actually I have no vices, I am a pure person. Or we practice a little bhakti and we become purified by that and we think that, oh, I have no vices. Now, when this happens, when we start thinking that we have no vices, actually that is an indication that we are in illusion. That the more we grow spiritually, at one level our vices decrease. But whatever vices are present within us, our awareness of those vices increases. That's why the great souls are always very humble. Even if they are greatly pure, they acknowledge that I have conditionings, I have so many impurities. And thus, they never feel themselves exalted. So, as long as we are self-conscious, it means we think of how great I am, we don't think of how great Krishna is, then we stay no vices. We imagine that we have no vices, and that imagination is an illusion. That illusion is indicative of our lack of spiritual advancement. So what do we do in such a situation? We need to recognize that even if we seem impure, even if we seem pure, we are not pure. We still have impurities. And with humility, we approach Krishna. We approach the process of bhakti, seeking purification, and thus, that's how we grow. So, Krishna talks about this in 2.11 in the Bhagavad Gita, when he tells Arjun that Ashochanan Vashochastvam Pragyavadamscha Bhashase Gatasuna Gatasumscha Nanu Shochanti Panditaha. So, he says that Arjun, you are speaking learned words, but actually your emotions are that of an uneducated person. You are lamenting like an ignorant person, and therefore you are actually ignorant. So when Arjun has been quoting scriptural verses and philosophical points, giving ethical arguments, he is speaking like a learned person. But at that time, or despite all his arguments, he is unaware, he is uninformed. And Krishna points that out. So, when we have humility, then we understand that actually I have a long way to go in my spiritual life. And I need to practice bhakti steadily, with humility and with steadiness. When we do that, then we will move forward steadily. So, Arjun did not have vices specifically, but he did have an illusion at that time, and because he was speaking with as if he were learned, he was thinking that he knew everything already. But then Krishna pointed out that he did not know. So similarly for us, rather than thinking we have no vices, whenever that thought comes in, I am pure, we have to understand that that is indicative that I am a novice. Instead, we acknowledge the impurities within us and strive diligently to practice bhakti, then we will become purified. And then, even when we come to the state of having no vices, we won't be proud of that. We won't be arrogant about it. Rather, we will be so absorbed in Krishna and reciprocating love with Him that we won't feel any self-congratulation about being free from vices. Rather, we'll be absorbed in Krishna and delighting in that absorption. So, claiming to have no vices is itself a sign of illusion. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita in 5.23 that you need to tolerate lust and anger throughout our lives. Chaknoti hai vaya sodhum prakshareer vimokshanat kama krodhodbhavam vegam sayukta sasukhi narah. So he says we can stay well connected and we can stay satisfied when we acknowledge that vices like desire and anger, they arise simply from being in an embodied condition and we tolerate them without indulging in them. So thus, by tolerating, Krishna says, we will advance and attain the transcendental stage. Thank you. Hare Krishna.